You have all had the opportunity to get involved with the medical seva happening across Tamil Nadu. There are plenty of opportunities available to participate in medical seva. To brief us on the seva activities undertaken in Tamil Nadu, we have with us Dr. Ram Manohar Rao. Dr. Ram Manohar Rao, MBBS, MD, has been practicing as a consultant family physician for more than 3 decades. He has been National Secretary and National President of Indian Association for the Study of STD and AIDS. He is the recipient of the Best Doctor Award by Indian Medical Association. He has served the Sri Sathya Sai Seva organizations at various capacities, including being the Chief Medical Coordinator for the Sri Sathya Sai Healthcare Project Chennai and the National Medical Coordinator for Sri Sathya Sai Seva Organizations India. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Ram Manohar Rao to give us a broad overview on the medical seva in Tamil Nadu.
Om Sri Sai Ram. Offering my humble pranams at the divine lotus feet of beloved Bhagawan, I pray to Bhagawan to guide me through this presentation. Respected elders, brothers and sisters, let me start with a Swami sayings. It's an advice to the doctors. If the doctor is full of love and compassion, God works through him. Doctors therefore have to endeavor to become receptacles of the divine power during their healing process. The divine direction for Medicare for the 21st century, once again I quote Bhagawan, make love the capsule that you offer to your patients. Anything you do with love will be rewarding. We start the medical activities with amazing Sai Krupa, which was started in the year 1977. And the Sai Krupa in Aryapuram is just a stone's throw distance away from this place. The other Sai Krupa's functioning would be at Annanagar, Ashok Nagar, Nungambakkam, Chinmayanagar, Gilnagar, Thandiyapet, Ayambakkam. And finally, the Karukon, Avadi and Red Hills have been merged with the mobile hospital. This is just a data to tell about Aryapuram Sai Krupa. About 8,026 patients were seen last year. Now, this is a bar diagram. If you can see that, the number of patients have come down, and last year only 8,262. I'm sure Bhagawan would like this slide and this data. If I quote an incidence, in the yesteryears, when Dr. Vijay Kumar mentioned to Swami, Swami, these are patients have increased, the immediate thing Swami said was in Telugu, meeru chala baga treat chestunte patients taggala gaani peragakoddu. That means if we treated the patients properly, the patients should have gone down and not increased. So that is what this slide says. But the reality is the comprehensive scheme of the insurance of the chief minister and the advent of the medical camps and to a certain extent the migratory population have brought down the number of patients to Sai Krupa. And this is all Sai Krupas put together, about 14,379 patients have been screened last year. And this gives an overall picture of the medical camps being conducted by Sathya Sai Organization Tamil Nadu. We do the general medical camps, the eye camp, the dental camp, the blood donation to a certain extent, the gynec camp, the ENT camps, diabetic camps, mental health camps, and mobile medical camp. Overall, about 2,323 camps have been conducted last year, and the number of beneficiaries were about 1,66,231. The medical service also continued under the Sri Sathya Sai Village Integrated Program under the title Medicare. Right now, 48 villages are being served with the seva, and doctors go there periodically to render medical seva under this program. This is the Margrel village, which has been adopted by the Chennai Metro South. Mobile medical units, I will not touch upon this since Dr. Mohan, who has been involved right from the inception in this project, he will enlighten more on these mobile medical units. Sri Sathya Sai Healthcare Project in Chennai, when Bhagawan is here in the 2007, he inaugurated this project on the 28th of January. Doctors having their own private hospitals and diagnostic institutions have come forward to offer one bed totally free of cost for the benefit of the poor and needy. The poor patients screened in the rural camps, etc., are the beneficiaries and not the relatives of the office bearers of Sri Sathya Sai organization. It's a clear, strict instruction that has been given to the hospitals to accept only the patients who are referred by the organization. The patient is taken care of by the hospital. The attender of the patient is taken care of the samiti, which is referring the patient to the hospital. As far as the patient is concerned, not a single paisa is spent from his pocket. And healthcare service rendered by institutions are done without any discrimination based on religion, language, caste or creed. Swami is blessing this project. Blood donation camps. See, normally we say it should be done based on the demand and supply. But sometimes the number of units taken in that blood donation camp exceeds that of the demand. So most of the blood is being wasted. So to overcome this thing, Chennai Metro has started what is known as a 24 hours liquid love information services. This was officially inaugurated on 6th of December 1998 at Sundaram. It works from 6 to 10 p.m. and 28 volunteers man this seva. Around 4,000 volunteer donors are on the database presently. This seva is being rendered on average to 100 to 220 patients every month. All the doctors chant Sai Gayatri while the blood is being collected from them, thereby spiritualizing the blood which is being given to the patient. Doctors go to super specialized hospital for rendering seva, the cardiac screening OP. This project was started way back in 1999, and Tamil Nadu doctors were blessed by Bhagawan to start this seva. Initially, 3 doctors were going. Now, only 1 doctor is being sent, because already 1 doctor is permanently there, and the seva is for 10 days. Accommodation and food arrangements for doctors renting this seva is totally free, taken care by Sri Sathya Sai Central Trust. Initially, Tamil Nadu was given this chance, but now all over India, people have blocked the dates. You can see that different states have come forward, and these doctors render seva meticulously on the day they have been given that thing. Maharashtra has taken the entire from January to March, like that all states have been given the opportunity. Similarly, the doctors from here are sent to General Hospital also for doing seva for a minimum of 4 days. Same way, they are also given free accommodation, food arrangements. Doctors, the basic MBBS qualification, are eligible to do the seva. See, Sathya Sai patient rehabilitation program. Even after treatment, people suffer from the disabling sequelae of illnesses that can interfere with their daily life. It is during this difficult phase of their life that they require specialized care that adds their physical, psychological, and social well-being. On this basis, this SRP program has been commenced in Tamil Nadu, apart from other states also. Last year, about 980 patients were rendered seva, and 65 of them are used to participate in the SRP medical camps, and 473 patients are being served at their residences, and some of them are coming for Parthi Yatra as well as seva at Puttaparthi. 136 of them have voluntarily offered to do seva. Medical Seva as part of disaster management, we have been seeing wherever disaster management, the first organization which jumps into Seva is Sathya Sai Seva organization. And here our doctors also take part in that. Recently, 2015 disaster in Chennai also during the floods, and as well as in Kerala, etc., the doctors have been doing. So Tamil Nadu is no way lagging behind as far as the medical Seva is concerned in disaster management. Swami says, please take care of the animals also. He's also very close to Swami. Kanchi South, Tiruvallur, Viluppuram have been doing some veterinary camps. Last year, about 4 camps were conducted, screening about 1,335 animals. Finally, I would like to appeal to all the doctors, brothers and sisters present here, to kindly induct your children and grandchildren into this medical seva so that they also share the love and the grace of our beloved Bhagawan. Now, the future plans as envisaged by our state medical coordinator, Dr. E. Prabhu. Strengthening the existing Sai Kripas by uniting the smaller units and forming main skills training hub. To revisit the Sri Sathya Sai Young Adult Program and initiate the training of trainers in basic health and hygiene. Screening of young adult girls for anemia, hyperproteinemia, hyperthyroidism and polytrauma and stress disorders. Super specialty consultation services at Sai Kripas in major metros. Bi-monthly satsang on Sai health programs to all youth from rural areas and in corporates. Jai Sai Ram. I thank the organizers and also beloved Swami for having given me an opportunity to make this presentation. Jai Sai Ram.
Thank you, Dr. Ram Manohar Rao, for giving us a brief overview of the medical seva in Tamil Nadu. It's heartening to see that Swami has not only reached lakhs of medical patients for medical treatment, but I'm sure he has entered their hearts and transformed many lives forever through the yeoman service rendered by our doctors with love.